Hi, this is Steven from Realtime Casting. This time showing you a quick demonstration of how to use Realtime Casting to audition for voiceover work. When you go to the home page, simply log in to your account. Going to log into my test account here. And it will take you to your dashboard. Now, if you're not a premium member, what's going to happen is that you won't see this message that I'm pointing out there. What you will see, though, is a message on the top saying that you have to make a payment via PayPal. But instead, though, this time, though, because I am a premium member, I'm going to show you exactly how to audition. If there's an audition that you've received, you may get an email about it. From that email, you may have to log in before seeing the audition. But if you're logged in first, you may see a little number next to the envelope here. When you click on it, it's going to open up all of auditions in the past, and the ones that are still dark gray are ones that you can still submit for. The ones that say selected instead of invited, these were older texts used during testing, and I'm going to try to submit during this one. So let's see, script, you could just see that I have script there, notes, criteria, audition for the project. Now, from here, you pretty much do the auditing or the editing of your audio on your own from your computer at home. But when you have a selected, when you have a file ready to submit, click on the button there, select the file, and then submit the audition. If you've already submitted an audition to a project, you're going to get a message at the top that tells you so. Although it says you can overwrite your audition, currently this is in work, and we are making sure that you can actually do that. But right now it does not work. So now, though, if you need to, let's say you've already submitted to it, go check out a different job that you've gotten for the day. And click on this one here, St. John Fisher College, and let's see, you read the notes down here describing what has to be read in the script, and there's a print button up here if you want to click on that. It will help you print out the script. Click on select file, and submit audition. The audition was submitted successfully. And that will then take me to all of the auditions that I've submitted in the past. You could even view the project, and you can listen to your auditions.
Hey, Eric, look at this.
I need a better audio sound.
Okay. So, really from here, though, when you're seeing them on this page, it means that your audition has gone through. As the website grows and as we get more members to it, we'll be able to add features that, you know, reassure you that the audition was listened to. Things like that, that kind of give you more communication and more insight into what's actually going on beyond this page. But if you are seeing it on this page right here, it means that your audition did go through. After you've auditioned for a job, you can go back and edit your profile, look at my demos, view your profile. One of the things I actually like to do, just as sort of like a point of making it part of the regimen, I like to, you know, share my profile after an audition is submitted. Okay. Now, you can share it on, share your profile and your demo on, on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And I suggest doing it. You know why, though, really? It's good to do is just to get yourself out there and just say, I just submitted an audition for, I submitted an audition for a promo, for a commercial, for this job, you know, good luck to everybody. Do something social that gets your profile out there that shows that you're a working voiceover actor. Okay, so from there, that's really all there is to submitting auditions on Realtime Casting. And I hope you appreciated this this demonstration. If you have any questions for me, you can reach out to support@realtimecasting.com. Thanks so much.